Yes, we're back. We're back again in Tourist Bus. We're back, and this time for something really, really special. Yes, it's new coach time. And finally, yes, something that's going to be brilliant on this island. It's down there. The VDL Futura series. We've got them in Tourist Bus. We've got them in Firm Bus. Let's go and check them out. Grab that guidebook to teeny tiny little coaches. And let's go. So hi there, Steve here, and yes, welcome back to Tourist Bus, and yes, welcome to this first look at the VDL coaches. We're going to start on Tourist Bus with the smallest of the coaches, which is this one here. Released a video on the same day as this one, looking at the longest coach in Firm Bus, but yeah, wanted to have a look at the shortest one, because this thing is going to be absolutely ideal for Tourist Bus, I think. Perfect length. For those shuttle services and everything that we get around the island, and it is very, very well done. It just looks absolutely brilliant. Looks really, really nice, really well styled, and yeah, one of a number of lengths that we get. Recorded the video, which I'll put in now, showing you the various lengths. It is taken from the selection screen in Firm Bus, so apologies for that. Let me just put that in now. So there we go. So that's this version here, the 106, the smallest one of the bunch, but yeah, perfect for Tourist Bus. Then we go to a longer version, the 122. That I think will also work well in Tourist Bus, but it's going to be really, really good for Firm Bus as well. So that's going to be really, really nice. Then from the 122, we go up to the 129, slightly longer again. Again, brilliant for Firm Bus. Going to be interesting taking that around some of the roads here on the Fuerteventura. That's certainly going to be interesting. And the 135, certainly going to be really, really interesting with that one as well. That's really, really long, but not the longest. The 139, slightly longer again, but a twin rear axle. And yeah, you think that was long? Yeah, there's another one to come. The 148. Yeah, that thing is pretty long. So yeah, that's the one we looked at in the video that went out earlier in Firm Bus. But yeah, I wouldn't want to take that around some of the roads here on the island, but I will as a bit of a challenge. So let's have a look inside then. Again, perfect size, I think, for the island of Fuerteventura. Absolutely brilliant. Really, really nice dash as well. So I'm taking a few screenshots here. Is really well done. Let's put the electrics on. And start it up. Now let's close everything. So we'll activate our destination display, although I'm not actually going to do the journey. Steering wheel is a little bit upright. That's fine with me. Don't mind that at all. I'm sort of getting used to it as well. So let's pop it in gear. I seem to have got a light going on. That's because I've... Yeah, I didn't shut me... I left my door open. There we go. Let's try that. But yeah, it looks and sounds really, really nice. So this is going to be the perfect length, I think, for here. So let's just stop there a second. So controls slightly different for this one. So front door controls are here. Driving lights on and on, passenger lights on, reading lights on, left luggage doors, right luggage doors, play the announcement, driver monitor on or off, passenger monitor on or off, which are up there, restroom clearance on, Wi-Fi clearance on, particle filter on, and you're wondering where the air conditioning is, it's over here. So driver's windows are on, front lifts up and down are on, window shades on, destination display on or off is down there. And it's that, well, there's a display. So I'll try and remember what it is myself. That one. Gears. All right, do apologize. ESP says more control, lights are on there. Why isn't it taking me to the air conditioning? It's there. There we go. It was on that one. That's right, it's me being a Muppet. There we go. So the air conditioning one was on there. So air conditioning is there, which you can set. So that's over on this side now. So rather than being on the other side, it's over here on the driver's side now. But yeah, looking really, really nice. And drives really well. So I think this is going to be the definite go-to coach for those journeys around the island. As I say, being the shortest version, I think this is going to be anyone's go-to. And as I'm recording this, there isn't a Steam Link yet. Well, this is going out on the day of release. There isn't a Steam Link yet to be able to purchase it. I will, if I am able to, though, on the day it goes live, I will add that link below. But yeah, really, really nice, this thing. So this is just a shorter version. I will bring a full video out later this week. I am planning to do a couple of streams, one in Firm Bus, one in Taurus Bus, this week. So there will be both those streams where I'll be spending a lot longer with these coaches, coming out in those streams, so full journeys with them. And so we'll have a look through this thing, because this is going to be the go-to one for me in Taurus Bus, and we'll go with the longest version in Firm Bus. But yeah, I think this is absolutely fantastic. So the whole range of coaches you get, I think you'd be a brave man to try and, or woman, to try and take these out in, take the longer ones out in Taurus Bus, that's for sure. But yeah, really, really well done. It is a brilliant, brilliant coach, or range of coaches. So yeah, more to come from me. Just wanted to put out a quick little video on the day of release, just to say that they are available now. And don't forget, along with this, you've only got to buy the DLC once. So if you buy the DLC for Firm Bus, you automatically get it for Taurus Bus. So if you've got both games, you haven't got to buy it twice. You've only got to buy it once, which is something brilliant, I think, that TML are doing, which is really, really good of them. So rather than have to buy it for each game, you only buy it once and you get it for both games. But yeah, this thing looks stunning. So there'll be a full video coming from me. As I said, I'll do a Twitch stream this week, so keep your eye on Twitch. I'll do a Twitch stream this week in both Firm Bus and Taurus Bus, where we'll spend a lot longer in each of the two coaches. But yeah, new things, and they are really, really nice things as well. What a great looking coach that is. And yeah, I think the perfect size for use with Taurus Bus. I think this will be my go-to coach, because rarely do we get a lot of passengers. So I think something like this in Taurus Bus is absolutely ideal. I'm just going to have a fleet of these. That's it. I'm done. I won't need anything else. Capacity-wise, how many people we can get on here? So 4, 8, 12, 16, 18, 20, 24, 28, 32, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40 passengers. Now, it's not very often I've done journeys, or done any journeys at all, with 40 passengers on. So I think this thing is going to be the ideal. the one coach to rule them all. So there we go, I will end that there. Keep an eye out for the video, which I will put up later in the week. Don't forget to check out my other content as well. Normal stuff from me is OMSI the Bus Simulator on a Monday, something from Train Sim on a Wednesday, and something from either Firm Bus or Taurus Bus on a Friday, with occasional something from X-Plane as well on a Saturday. So quick little video, there'll be a full run through and look again at the whole coach coming up in the next couple of days. Hope you enjoyed that. I'm certainly looking forward to spending a lot longer in this thing. It's brilliant. Until the next time, if you have been, thanks very, very much for watching.